You know, you've got to be shrewd, smart. And listen to this. It's not just the devil, but the world is more clever, more shrewd than we are. I hope you believe me in seducing people from Christ than we are to getting people to follow Christ. Do you believe that?
Yes.
You're more clever, much sharper. Please, once again, I guess it's synthesized a definition that is known as Luciferian conspiracy against the truth. Here it is. This is Marshall McLuhan. The modern media are engaged in a Luciferian conspiracy against the truth. The modern media are engaged in a Luciferian conspiracy against the truth. And that I subscribe to with my whole heart. And that is why the document of the Second Vatican Council on the media called Inter Mirlifica of the 16 documents of Vatican II that has been the most neglected in the Catholic Church since the close of the Second Vatican Council. And the reason is obvious. That document tells Catholics, tells bishops, use the media to proclaim the gospel, to evangelize. And I think I've told you on some occasion, when Pope Paul VI ordered a Carmelite abbot to come to the United States and do something to wake up the sleeping Catholics in America, to use the media to proclaim the Catholic faith. 10 of us were assembled. The others had millions. I had zero. But I was part of the 10 people that were organized. Remember, I told you. The abbot, about a year after his first meeting with us, he go back to Rome. He brought to the Holy Father what we decided. If anything happens to me, the abbot told me, I want you to take over my mission, the Holy Father. He said, look, I'm a nobody. You are a relative of Pope Paul VI. You're an abbot. Don't let me tell the Holy Father. Call him the Holy Father. 2 weeks later, the abbot was found dead in bed. And for now, over 20 years, I've been trying to wake up American Catholics to that mandate I received from the Vicar of Christ. Wake up Catholics to use the media to teach the Catholic faith. They listen. They blink. They say their prayers. And nothing. That's my mother, Angelica. And by the way, if the Lord allows me to write the autobiography, part will be my relationship with Mother Angelica. We know each other very well. Because the devil is clever. The devil always mixes truth with error. But I can tell you this, so much of the modern world is behaving as though there was nothing sacred. Is human life sacred from the moment of conception in the mother's womb? That life sacred?
Yes.
Does it belong to God? Yes. And Catholic churches, even in some meeting halls, there'll be more restraint and more reverence than some people nowadays practice when are allegedly Catholic churches. And I think I told you about the boy in a Catholic high school, a junior, was forbidden by his teachers. He was watched. He would regularly kneel during the consecration. He's told by the principal, either you stop kneeling or you will be expelled from the school. As I speak to you, I say to myself, or tell the Lord, Lord, what would I have to say? What in your name, dear Lord, would I have to say to wake up our Catholic people to the revolution through which we are going in our country today? Far deeper than any of us, including I, can recognize.